any second, guys.
They weren't announcing.
Beatbox.
12, right?
Yeah. Right. God, that's... So we'll start off with that real quick, all right? Beatbox.
Any second.
All right, here we go. Any fucking second, guys. Get ready.
I don't know what their deal's going to be,
hang out with us.
Even if they just give me free people.
Guys, I'm going to these conversations.
Oh, my God, I'm in heat right now. We're live.
Yes, we are. That's who we are.
We are live.
Comments are on right now.
Okay.
We all look handsome.
We look good.
That's insane, guys. We'll wait a little bit. Wait a little
bit. Let me drop the link.
Drop that shit, girl.
Let me drop the link. Can I get that link?
All right, cool. I thought they caught us when you were on my lap.
Hey, thank God they didn't.
No, thank God.
I don't need the heat, especially from your new hyena.
I know, my old ass fucking hyena.
Your beach hyena.
Yeah, so she's a son of a beach. Life's a beach, right?
Let me see. Copy.
All right, we're on, guys. Give us a little bit. We're going to wait for more people to come on. But thank you for joining. We're just going to have some casual conversation.
Casual Thursday on?
Yeah, we're just right here chilling. Casual. Marlo's here. Damn.
Badger.
Man, the honey badger. Got Sinful.
Sinful.
Man, we got Jay Nasty. The Pounder at 4 a.m., 5 a.m.
China.
Nasty.
Is that what you're known on the street, the Pounder?
Life's a beach.
That's hot.
Well, they call him the after hour Pounder because it was like, this was walking away.
Why are you going out of the room for? What happened?
Because
you should be proud.
But it was a guy.
It was a guy, though. It was a guy.
Oh, that's what you.
Yeah, and it's fine. Just
own that shit, my boy.
Because you like butt stuff, anyways. A guy has the same butt as a girl's butt.
Let's just be real honest.
Gus?
All you men like butt stuff. Let's just be real honest. You don't want to admit it sometimes.
Tone's talked about it. We'll talk about it right now.
I'm sure you do. I mean,
we'll get into that.
I'm not. It's not a specialty of mine.
Get into ass.
You know, we'll talk about a little
bit
of butt action.
I said it live on the Shaka thing, bro, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, so we've talked about butt stories.
Yeah.
So
yeah, you better be ready. Like normal.
You better be ready for your butt story.
I don't have a butt story.
Nope, you better fucking make one up, Angie B, because you brought this up.
I didn't bring it up. You guys said it was
no.
Boys,
you literally said
butt stuff.
Everyone loves butt things.
After you said he likes butt stuff,
you said
I just
everyone
make him feel comfortable. Everybody likes butt stuff.
There you go. You brought it up.
Exactly.
Fine, whatever. Fine.
What's up,
I
everybody?
Stand by my comment.
How are we doing?
We're doing good right now. I think
How was your day?
Almost 100 people on.
My day was good. It was good. It was good. I was not as productive as I would want it to be. But I, you know, I don't want to say I was hungover because I don't want to have that defeat.
Yeah.
But I was sluggish.
Gotcha.
You know,
Rosé, you're on right now. Rosé, how does the volume sound right now? Can somebody do an audio check real fast before we start?
Is that the real Rosé or is that the one that was trying to fuck?
No, this one is the SF. I don't know. Jay Nasty,
From South Fontana?
Please?
Adriana Mota. That's a great last name.
Mm-hmm. Watch my old lady.
Like, what's your name?
Some singer I knew, her name was Anita, and her last name was Blunt. And it was Anita Blunt.
Anita Blunt.
Pretty good?
Rosé, SF, all right. Veronica.
Sounds good, guys. Get ready to rock and roll.
Veronica.
Here we go, guys.
All right, guys. Start telling your people we're live. Let's make it happen.
Everybody sounds good. Hey, Adrian Mota. Rosé, we sound good. Veronica Dorado. Everybody sounds good. Because we're about to fucking rock and roll right now. And once you rock and roll, we ain't stopping because there's no breaks in this fucking podcast.
Let's go, baby.
All gas, homie. You want to catch a fade?
Not today.
All right. So sure.
Not today.
Let's fucking rock this shit. Everybody rock this shit.
Look at that, Tom.
Evan Valdez, what's up? Joker, what's up? Cubel. You guys all.
This episode is brought to you by Rockley Media in Covina, California.
Yeah. When I wake up, I mean,
you do dream.
Pretty loud and clear, Raquel. Go on.
Yes. But like, oh my God, it's about a
girl that I once knew. What up, everybody? What's good?
She took my love.
Hope you're ready. We brought my ex into the motherfucking podcast today.
G-Money, are you ready for this fucking shit, my boy?
I've been ready, baby. You already motherfucking know.
Let's fucking go!
Let's go! Welcome to No Lames. We got the beautiful DJ Angie V in the motherfucking building.
Hey!
I got my boy Rocky Nash on the ones and twos. And I got the one and only High Tone. You already know what you're tuned into. Everybody, let's go!
Fucking bomb right now.
keep away from a runaround soon.
Come on.
It's about to get cracking, guys. Thank you for tuning in. We got the baddest motherfucking podcast in the world.
Jimmy, one more time for the band.
You know I keep away from a runaround soon. And you girls can keep away from a runaround soon. We're keeping away from a runaround soon.
So, Angie, I don't know if you know, you're a DJ. You play a lot of songs.
She does.
And maybe some songs you don't know what they mean. Do you know what a runaround soon is?
Absolutely. This was like the first post song. I would say the first, you know, the dictionary says that Runaround Sue was the first ho song about hoes.
Have
you
like the original thought song?
Yeah, so
huh?
You know, we
have you had any Sue
the
in your life?
No.
You never ran into a Sue?
She's just you're being.
Or are you the Sue?
Are you running for mayor? It's
me.
She's a Sue.
DJ Angie Sue on the ones and twos. What's going on here?
Angie, you have a busy schedule. First of all, I want to thank you for making time to come out here.
No,
like, you're
a
busy chick. Like, Angie, she don't like when this chick walks in the room. It's like, give me $2,000. Like, she's.
Yeah.
She earned that. She earned that shit for you coming out here, like, cause you don't have too much like spare time to come and chill, like, and for you coming here, like, thank you ahead of time.
Thank you. No, I appreciate that. Definitely not these next 2 weeks. No, but you know what I mean. It's a fun break to kind of like clear my mind. So I like
you need it. Everyone needs it. You know?
Absolutely.
No, and you know what? Like Rock said, thank you. We're gonna probably say that a lot because it does mean a lot to have you here.
Thanks.
And I know I met you at You're Not Down. So can we give a fucking round of applause for You're Not Down.
That's fucking
If
dumb.
You want to explain what You're Not Down is to the people, and then we'll give our what You're Not Down is from my point of view, from my perspective.
Okay.
You're going.
Yeah.
Because I'm fucking down. Dog. Same, check
You're
my
Not Down is a party that I created probably, God, man, maybe like 8 years ago. It's been a long time.
Wow.
Yeah, a really, really long time.
You were straight back then.
No.
I'm kidding.
No, not then. Come on, no. Yeah, I created a long time, and it was basically, I was just really tired of playing a lot of the same shit every weekend, as most DJs do. You know, we play the same shit. And at the time, there wasn't really anything other than it was hip-hop, EDM, like, but heavy hip-hop. So Adam Pun had asked me if I wanted to take over the small patio at Detox. Do you guys remember Detox?
Of course.
That was, like, the big party in Pomona. Yeah. It was very hip-hop-oriented.
It seemed like county jail or, like, a jail where, like... The blacks are in this yard, and the Mexicans are in this yard. It was literally separated.
Yeah.
It was separated, bro.
It was definitely General Pop, but it was also
General
really cool.
Pop.
It was also really cool that you had a very large amount of Latinos and a very large amount of blacks, because it was popping.
It was
cool.
It was
sold out all the time.
There was really no fights or anything.
Rarely.
It was cool.
So, yeah, he asked me to take the small one, and I said, okay, well, I will, but I have this idea. I don't want to play, like, I want to do a very specific party. I want to play the old school. And he was like, I don't really care what you do. Like, do whatever you want.
Yeah.
So it was tiny. It was started really, really small. Our first one was at the Green Room on a Thursday night. It kind of was like 20 of my friends there. And then we went up to Detox, and it slowly, like, I think the first season was fun. We learned it. And then season two, I think you've been to the rooftop one, right?
Man, that's where I got started. Like, I would go, come home, you want to do the hip-hop shit?
Yeah.
I go, dude, that music up there, I feel like I'm in a quinceañera or a wedding. I need to go up there, and it just...
Because it wasn't around at the time.
It was just a different vibe.
A 15-year-old girl?
Because downstairs, it's still a roof. It's more like homies. I mean, I'm not disrespecting anybody, but homies standing on couches and a whole popping ball. It's a pissing contest. You go up there, Angie V... Hey, if you're not ready to fucking dance with a fucking tall can, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
It was just straight a vibe.
Yeah, honestly,
it was real. It was like pretty much, I felt like it was a barbecue vibe.
That was my goal. So it's always meant to look or feel like a backyard boogie, right?
Yeah.
Like, so if you go to You're Not Down, if you look at the graphics in the tent, all the bottle service sections are picket fences. And, you know, we put, like, we wanted each little section to feel like a little mini backyard. You get an ice chest.
Yeah.
So that was, like,
they
part of the concept.
They stole those ice chests.
Do
that no more, huh?
Yes, man. We do.
Do you feel like, because you did start at that, and also you escalated really quick with that Derby Room now, where now it's, like, thousands of people.
Yeah.
But now, like, for me personally, it's not that intimate vibe. Like, it's not that barbecue. It's like, damn, it's like a daytime party.
It's
like,
a
I'm just, oh, I'm a grouch.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
But I just, you know what I mean? So it's
different.
It is different.
I think there's pros and cons to it because 100%. as you know, a DJ like Angie, the goal is to continue to grow.
Yes.
You feel me? And get bigger.
Definitely.
But when you do those things, you do lose the intimacy and the, like, the being able to connect with the people that have been there from day one. But if they fuck with you and love you, they're going to be happy for you. You know what I'm saying? Because absolutely, when you go from the alley in Pomona to the Derby Room, like, it goes from a backyard party to now, like, a full-blown day club in Vegas. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't really get to see the people that you typically would see.
Wrong. Yes and no. I created, so, the friends and family, which most people that don't know us call it VIP. It's not VIP. It's friends and family. I'm really, really, really very, very specific about who is back there.
Yeah.
Everyone is named. Like, it's not, yo, I'm pulling up with 10 friends. Yeah. It's no. If I know you and you can bring a guest, because I always wanted to keep that intimate feeling.
Yeah.
I love, you know, it's so amazing to meet all these new people. And I know you know it. Like, they follow you. They know you. They think you know, they know you very well. They know your friends. I signed up for this life, but my friends didn't. So a lot of times, like, they just want to come and have a good time and party, but they feel maybe they can't be themselves because, you know, certain people that they don't know are around. So I'm very, very, very passionate.
Yeah, and definitely the backstage is definitely still intimate.
Absolutely.
It's like a rooftop by backstage.
But I think that's fucking
awesome, bro. That you even keep that in your heart and head, because, like, it's the epitome of someone that doesn't forget. Mm-hmm. Where they started and where they came from. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's why people love you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're good place no matter what. Like,
and I have to feel good too. Like, I love You're Not Down. I love doing it. So if it's all about just doing it for everyone else, it takes the love of that I have for it. I love when my girl, like, I'm black. Y'all see, I'm blacked out, like, every time. Yeah. Because I'm genuinely also having the time of my life. I love like, it.
Even sometimes I have that they carry you, like, you're like, she stage dives now, and they have her. And G Money has a thing. We had a competition one time. It was back in the days. It was still in the alley.
Yeah.
Let's who max the most lesbians down.
Wait, hold on. Before
we're not going into that right now.
Let me talk.
Thanks, we're talking
Michelle. A lot. Please right do. Now. We're waiting for you to talk.
We have. Everyone's like, when's G Money gonna fucking light the show up, dog? Real quick. I love You're Not Down. I love what you do with it. It's fucking amazing.
Thank you.
I love going. My first time at You're Not Down, I was like, damn, this place is cool. It feels like I'm with all my fucking uncles.
Yeah.
A couple of my gay uncles.
Yeah, yeah.
And all my fucking tias.
Yeah.
Couple that are, when they drink a little too much, they go down on each other.
100%. 100%.
And then I was like, dude, everyone's so cool. Like, everybody was so fucking nice. Like, I was loving the motherfucking vibe, right? I fucking love it to this day. Like, now it's getting a little too much people where now, like, the cholos are finding out that it's cool.
Yeah.
And we're like, cholo, stop, fool. Like,
well, this, we like, definitely.
You're like, cracking down on it. I don't know.
100%.
But, like,
they're not cracking down on who's coming in.
I think.
But
they,
just understanding
they
want
to go to a fun time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, most of the ones that I met there are fucking cool. Like, you know what I'm saying? But it's crazy because you see, like, gay cholos too. And I'm like, damn, what's
crazy? Yeah, actually.
They're hitting on me, but it's a different type of hitting. Like,
hey, free drinks, a free drink.
Yeah, right?
100%.
I don't give a fuck. Where is
no,
it?
But
your eyes, it's all the
I was
thing,
like,
you know?
Oh, this is the coolest fucking party. But I didn't realize how many fucking gays love me, Doug. Like, I have, like, believe it or not, I love the gays. And they are like, so fucking cool with me and Rock, for sure. I don't know what it is, but we have a big gay following. It probably has to do with you.
I don't think it has to do.
I'm going
to
tell you, be very honest. Uh-huh. I will say that I think every time I happen to pop in on your guys' chats, y'all are talking about some gay shit. Now, either A, they love that.
Most
straight
guys talk about gay shit.
Like, all the time.
It's weird.
So we need to get to the root of maybe there's, I don't know, you know?
Take it easy,
like,
Angie.
You're like, I don't know, I'm just saying.
Are they curious?
Are you curious? But I'm saying you're not afraid to speak about
no,
because
we're very secure. Like, we can say gay shit. We're not gay.
Yeah, like, you like butt stuff, but you're not gay. Yeah, for sure.
No, but I trip out on how G-Man said, like, the gay, like, when I first started Street Scholars, I was like anti-gay.
You hated
like gays. I don't want gays on a fucking show, the whole thing. And everybody's all, fool, you changed so much. Like, I go, I don't know where to get this
but
gay following
from. But
that's
also a really great, like, people are watching that.
Like, you're not,
so they're
like,
going
you're not
that
down, homie, out with that.
You're not
like,
down,
like, you're not down.
And they tell you dance
moves.
These
people are fucking amazing fucking people. Obviously, anything, there's fucking lame people too. But I was all, what the fuck? This was all fucking phobic about.
But this was what Rock was getting into, because we would go there and tell me what this is. And then we're gonna get into a lot of logic, because you're gonna explain.
Yeah. I mean, what terms. I think I know.
No, you know everything.
Because Hardest didn't do it.
Yeah.
So we got you here.
You got the job now.
I mean, you got a gold star.
I mean, we're definitely different types of on that spectrum of.
She's a stud. You're a fam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, right. We'll get into that.
Yeah, yeah, hold on.
We'll, like, we'll do gainies
so,
later.
Okay.
What is it when a bomb ass fool like me, right?
Uh-huh.
Just goes into this fucking gay establishment, right? Uh-huh. And I'm like, I see there's hot chicks, right? Like, I see a Marlo. Uh-huh. And Marlo's a bomb, right?
Right.
But, like, sometimes I'll fucking see a stud, and I'm like, I'm going to mack that fucking hyena stud right
now. Really?
Like, I think it's like a challenge, fool. Like, she has bomb Jordans like me.
I'm going to mack like, that hyena stud.
No, he done it, bro.
Hold on, Rocky's done it too, so I don't want Rocky to...
Wait,
I don't give a fuck. It was a long time
ago. My fucking second Modelo.
Okay, keep going. I want to hear this, so keep going.
No, but like I've been
You're
there.
You're asking me like, what do I
How
think that is?
How much have you drank?
Fool, I'm fucking waiting. I'm in. No,
it's 5 hours of drinking,
hey,
and you're never.
We're lying, calling Angie to get longer. In. Hey, fool.
Hey, we're pre-gaming.
Deny.
We're pre-gaming.
Still chicks, fool. They're real pretty.
And most of them have big tits, fool.
They have the hugest boobs.
Have the biggest.
Why are they trying to hide those fun bags? Let them go. Let them go and fly for everybody, man.
They don't want to let them fly. Some subs don't even want to have.
But this is what's weird because sometimes.
Do you
like,
want to have your chichis?
I mean, mine are nice.
You threw him in the.
I'm not
well, no, but I'm saying, not everybody wants, like, you know, like.
I mean,
everybody
no,
wants
I think
it.
They would wish they had mine because mine are man ones. There's a big. There's like have nice areolas and stuff.
No, big old nipples. Like nipples.
Yeah, see? That shit, you know what we're talking about?
Married, Angie, relax. Honestly.
I know. I'm sorry, Rock. I actually feel really weird about that. I'm so sorry.
Well,
shit.
Keep going right here.
You're not married.
Hey, get out of here. There's kids watching. But
so go with your stud mission.
Yeah. So what is it? Like, have you known of guys that are like, are me and Rocky the only ones that have max stud them?
You know what? To be perfectly honest, I don't know a lot of guys that have maxed a lot. But I also don't have a ton of stud friends.
There's like, a lot of studs there. I'm telling you that right now.
No, for sure.
Why don't you like them?
I don't
she
dislike
likes fans.
Them.
She likes fans.
But you don't like that like, you hate them?
No, not at all. Not even a little bit. I just, my homegirls is my homegirls.
I think because she know. Said one time, like, most studs are Democrats. And you don't like that. I think
I
said,
never
she
said
never
that.
Said that,
I
guys.
Never, ever
she never said that.
Said they vote for Biden.
But anyways, guys, you're not down. I mean, this is, we're not even trying to pitch it. She sells out in 24 hours. Like, this is not
no, it took a couple days.
Oh, God, sorry.
All right, yes. 72. Okay.
Yes.
It's
a good vibe. It's a good vibe.
No, it's a fun
party.
Vibe. I met Carrie there too.
Oh,
tell me, because he told me. So look at G Money told me. Goes, bro. Guess what? Can we always share information? He goes, guess what? I go, happy's all. I met Carrie. Dude.
Oh, happy. You were.
I go,
happy.
Carrie. I go, PE teacher Carrie.
PE teacher Carrie.
I go, no way, Carrie. Go, yeah.
Cargo shorts.
And then he has a video, and I'm playing a video right now. But he has a video of like
I do have
a headlock and is macking her down.
Yeah. That's probably the best kiss I mean, ever had
honestly,
in my life.
Carrie, if you're in here, I
fuck with G Money, bro. Like hey. You go in there, like you don't care if it's a femme, a stud,
no, I'm
a
girl,
bro. Like, I mean,
I'm
think that's awesome, bro.
Yes, fool. I just go to have a good time.
Just
fool.
And options you had a and good choices.
Time
doing
those I always have a good time.
But think about you're not down. If you
I was
go
down.
There, like you gotta leave.
I was fucking.
You gotta
down,
leave
bro.
Your marchiness at the door. Like you gotta go just have a fucking good time,
bro.
Dude. That's it.
I will. Okay, so it started very like you know we're older. You know we're older. The crowd is older. Mm-hmm. But I think with TikTok now, also this younger generation is embracing that life,
music,
that music, that life, like that's kind of it's culture. It's a cultural thing. It's Chicano culture. It is what it is, you know. And so I think TikTok has kind of changed things because now when you go to You're Not Down, there's little like really little
there's younger
kids
people
that
there.
I'm like,
yeah.
You know, just that you said we're older, so like they're normal age.
When's the next one?
Like you're
sold out already.
I feel like you're now. I feel like you're now. You're now like 30 and over. I feel like right.
No, now there's some.
Yeah, but we are getting a good chunk of like young kids that are just like, you know, they have the stees. They're on TikTok. Yeah. It's like a whole like lifestyle that's like changing. It's just like welcoming in that younger generation that
yeah, like,
appreciates
like,
it. Like
yeah.
you did.
TikTok is like
we didn't
like
have a place
their aunties
to go to
and
place.
Uncles that were
yes.
putting them on
yes.
game.
Yes.
Now TikTok could do that, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
I do want to dive into, let's just want to keep going here now. I do want to dive into a deeper thing since we do have her and we could get this thing out of the thing.
Okay.
I mean, we know the studs, fams.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, there's.
Ask here, we had a debate, and a lot of
we fucked up.
A lot of lesbians get you guys got it all fucking backwards. Okay, like, we don't know. Like,
so we had a conversation where we're talking about because to me, we now, didn't know.
Now let me just start off by saying I do not speak for all lesbians. I just speak for myself.
Just speak on the ones you went down on.
You're all dick.
I can either. That's not true. And I can neither confirm nor deny any of those allegations. Carry on.
Oh, speaking of Carrie.
About me. Carrie, cool. Let's go. Tell me what happened. What happened?
Is Carrie doing, anyways?
What happened?
Oh, so we want to
clarify
okay. the labels of.
Yes.
Because the gays.
Okay.
Girls, right? So we know there's a femme.
Uh-huh.
We all know that.
Okay. And then where do we go from there?
Studs.
There's a stud. What is considered the stud?
Dyke is very, the term dyke, and now again, I don't speak for everybody, but I feel like the term dyke.
Is that the F word?
Is like the F word.
It's like derogatory. It's
very derogatory. Yes. Okay. So when you say dyke,
that's what I'm asking you.
That's what she said.
Dyke is aggressive. Dyke is, it's been used to.
The F word, but for girls.
Yes. Okay. Correct. Like, you know, if you're going to speak on a broad term like this, probably not. You guys are talking to each other, whatever.
Oh, it's an insult.
It's
yes.
People can take it. Yeah, it's derogatory.
I call Lisa that all the time.
But that's your homie. That's your dog.
Okay, so yeah.
That's it's different. But if you're on a platform like this, it's different. So
yeah, okay, get it.
There's femmes, which are women that are very, you know, very feminine. There's stems.
Thanks, bro.
Which are, a stem is a stud femme.
No, but so
yeah, like okay. She's like studdish, but like
wears makeup and like still embraces kind of like their feminine
who's
energy.
Who's the stem that Sammy Joe the stem? She says he was
okay. If she yeah, if she identifies as a stem.
I think
okay,
Sammy
Joe
says she was a stem.
So like, it's like a yeah.
Wait, let's let her explain these things.
I would say a stem. Yeah, like a stem is a girl that the minute they walk in the door, you're going, is she or isn't she?
Oh, what
is she or isn't she gay?
That's who you.
That's
need
like a stem.
No, I want the ones that
there's women that walk in guys, that you know,
but they're gonna be like, you know, that's a bomb ass fool. Yeah. I gotta fuck that fool. Yeah. That's where I go for because I want to. I go in there to change their mind. Got let you. Them know fucking guys.
But
are cool,
a lot of gay fool or gay.
You're fighting for the guys.
I'm letting them know that they had a bad situation before, and this guy is gonna change their life. Yeah, and it happens.
Not all homosexuals have had bad experiences.
I know, but that's
they all didn't get raped.
Yeah,
by uncle.
Not every homosexual was molested. You know what I mean?
They say that.
That's definitely
every
not.
Every pastor's going to tell you that. Oh, like, did your uncle touch you when you were younger?
Yeah.
Like, hey, you know him?
Who told you?
All right, so femmes are.
Feminine girls. She walks pretty, in the room, you wouldn't even know they're gay.
Pretty lesbian chick.
Yes. I won't say. I mean, feminine girls looking.
I'm not being politically correct. I'm going to say they're the pretty ones.
No, right? I'm not going to say that.
Well, because there could be stems that are women fire, are beautiful. Too.
yeah,
Sammy Joe's pretty. If Sammy Joe's a stem, she's a pretty stem.
Okay, we're going to go take it in. So feminine. Yeah, very feminine. Okay. She walks in a room, you don't know she's gay.
Gotcha.
Usually a femme, right? Maybe you can tell by her little power suit or something. I don't know, but she's very womanly.
She has like a bracelet with like the flag.
Very womanly. Rainbow. There's stem, a girl that walks in a room and you're like, huh, she's kind of, I don't know, I can't tell. Like, she's super girly, but maybe she's, you know. And then a stud.
Would Carrie go under a stem?
Carrie wears a little bit of makeup. So
yeah, so I mean, she could be, like, you never know.
Carrie's, like, I would say personally, like, not stud. Yeah, I guess maybe, but, like, the end of the spectrum
maybe
before
it'll
stud.
It'll be like a Queen V with their basketball shorts, the big ones.
Let her finish her.
Fool, I'm just fucking talking to you. That's not a big deal.
Is she or isn't she? Carrie's like, you know, Carrie's that right in the center. Carrie's like that OG, you know.
All right. Yeah, so forget about identifying who they are. Now go into the next one.
And then a stud, which is a,
you know for a fact.
You know that like, you know, like she's like a guy. She's like a dude. She's
they're
like
proud of that
for
look.
Sure.
Like they want
the maybe fade, they don't even Jordans, want to be a woman. You know, like that would be more. I would say probably would be a stud. Yeah.
And there's
and then what's
else.
After that?
I mean,
full trans.
Full, yeah, I guess. Yeah, no, we'll full transitioning into being a man.
Get fucking banned already.
All right. So do
in my again, I'm an older girl. I don't really pay attention to titles or labels. That's not really my thing.
Okay,
I got something good.
Too.
I got a story.
Can you refresh it brand new, please? We're live right now, guys, by the way.
Okay, we're back.
All right,
we're
back.
Hey.
All right. I'll wait till everybody gets on real fast, then we'll just go. You know what the shit had? It had all the saved episodes from Street Scholars and all that. That's why no. Fucking, there was no fucking...
Like
I deleted everything. Yeah. It was fucking stupid.
Oh, shit.
Fucking Beetlejuice coming out. Can't wait for that.
I know.
Double date, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Opening weekend, I'm there. That was my favorite movie growing up. When I was little.
And just go to the live.
I'm talking nachos.
Nolan, go to the
hot
right.
Dog, a glizzy with no bun. Mm. Just mayo, dog. But you can't use your teeth. You have to just swallow.
Oh, okay. At least
it goes in. Here we go.
Butthole. It was live. You no, walked by a long time ago.
I went live right now. Yeah. We've been live for like 3 minutes already.
Yeah.
All right, Angie, serious question. I just want to dive straight into this. Okay. And obviously, like, not trying to be perverted by a real conversation. Like, yeah. It's funny, but at the same time.
Yeah.
But I'll give you an example. I was some chick, and every
That's
time.
That's my boy.
And hell yeah. And she was bomb.
Okay.
Nah, she wasn't. That's was my wife. But she was cool, right?
Okay.
And we vibe really good, and it was going really good, but every time we would have sex, it just smelled like hot box room kind of, and I got like weak stomach, like every time, so, Oscar. And it was cool, like, pretty girl, the whole thing, but I had to tell myself, do I really want to be with this girl long term if she smells every? Because now I don't want to have sex.
And like, and it's every time.
Every single time.
Okay, so it's not like she worked out. It's a long day. Like,
no,
it's every time.
Every single time.
Right. Right.
It is what it is.
That day.
So I had to. Do I just not be with her, or do I sit down? And go, hey, we should get that checked out, kind of deal. And it's a. There's never a good way of saying it.
No.
Like ever,
not.
But we just say, hey, babe, right. Like I think it smells a little bit. Like I don't know exactly my words, but I know we ended up at Kaiser. She had to get checked out. No, we did. Straight up. And then she had a fucking
the whole time she
had
like
to take some pills. And there's some kind of like her hormones balance with it. But
yeah,
sometimes
pH.
But sometimes I was talking about it because I started looking into it. But sometimes a girl won't smell, but if they get the same mixture with a certain dude, it'll smell. So sometimes a guy chemical with that with her chemical, it just it's not a good chemical together.
Yeah.
So sometimes it is a dude. And people go, oh, that bitch stinks. But oh, she only smells with you, not with that guy.
And that's
it's very possible. And for you being a girl going down a girl, because
that's
a
specialty.
I would imagine.
I heard you're good.
I would imagine that's especially for girls. Like, girl, if you're a lesbian, you're good.
Everyone says that. Like,
well, it's.
Not when she's good on the ones and twos.
Have you ever been, without saying names, obviously,
I would never.
Have you ever been in that situation where, like, damn, this girl kind of smiles?
No. Never.
Oh,
you
never.
Only go down on fresh chicks.
God.
You're lying.
This is
an
honest podcast,
I'm going to be very honest.
You're lucky.
She's lying.
I'm not lying. And the reason why I'm not lying is because I am not a promiscuous girl. I don't have casual sex. Not because I'm judgmental. I wish I could be a hoe. I wish.
Oh,
I just don't have that personality.
Wish
to
granted.
Where I can have casual sex with people.
Say this.
So I don't have a lot of. I don't have a ton of people under my belt. I'm very honest. That's the truth.
I mean, fuck.
So yeah, I have been very. I'm
you're
very
different.
Picky.
You're different.
G Money. Tony, never situation.
I have so
we love to hear it.
When I was younger, there was a girl that we named her Death.
Oh, was she a bomb?
Like she was so fire.
Is she on IG?
Super fire, bro. I this was when I was younger, bro. I don't know her IG, MySpace, nothing. So we named her Death because the juices on the sheets, bro. If you even just went 5 feet from the sheet, you would have thought they were storing a dead body under the bed, right? So her name was Death, right? But she was bad.
I like this girl.
So the homies would be like, bro, like maybe that was just a one-time thing. Like, fuck it. I'm gonna test it, bro. I'm gonna test it. I'm gonna take the risk, right? I'm gonna take the risk.
Yeah.
So now the other homie.
Everyone hoping for them.
Wait, so Death was not only a smelly pussy, she was just down for everyone?
She was just fuck, bro.
Oh, you know what was in there? Just all those old abortions just packed up in her fucking
soul.
Let's just put it this way. If all the homies are talking about how Death smells, I can understand perhaps.
Yes. Have you smelled cum later? It's probably all packed up with a bunch of old cum.
Yeah, hey, G-Man, you're probably right because after
thank you.
Me and that chick ended up breaking up, but you know you break with somebody, go, bro, that chick was a fucking hole, fool. Like, and then I find out, like, my neighborhood was, like,
like smacking.
You were with the hole?
How come homies didn't tell me when I was with this chick?
Here's the thing about the story.
You were with Death, what, 3 years?
No, he just smashed Death, right?
Oh, I don't know. It would seem like they were serious.
So stupid.
I had one encounter with Death.
In your head, you were thinking like, she's going to smell.
Wait, time.
Her
name
was Death,
question.
So I met her.
Okay, got it.
You gave her the name Death?
You gave her Death. Wow.
Right? You're disrespectful.
Maybe it's your chemicals.
Sometimes it happens. We actually
yeah. She's probably a fucking grandma right now that lives in Huntington Beach.
We would always talk about it, bro.
Blue eyes.
We would always talk about it. And so the homie's like, bro, like, if you're not going to smack again and try it again, then let me try it. Whatever. Anyways, finessed it. He tried it.
Mm-hmm.
Death again.
Oh.
So it was
death
like
before dishonor.
Could it stay that way forever? Like, I don't know, bro. Like, is she still death right now?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I will say this.
Great question.
That age, I know you're hormonally changing, but I don't think you're hormonally changing in the way that should. I could be wrong. I don't know, but I feel like that's too young. That sounds like poor hygiene.
Yeah. Okay, gotcha.
Honestly, like at that age, it just sounds. You said high school. It sounds like
no. Yeah, I was out of high school.
Because when you're young, you can process.
Yeah. So did you finish Tochon?
Of course you did. He's in high school.
Yeah, bro.
Wait,
two pumps and a quiver. Yeah. He was good.
But everybody wants. Everybody's asking, "How was she bomb or no?"
Yeah, sexy like moves.
Oh, if homies want to continue to take the risk and try death, then she was bad.
And fools are like, "Hey, you know what? I could fix death. I could change her."
They were hoping that when they had that experience,
resurrection vagina.
They're gonna take her to fucking Mako. She had a salvage title.
CCLA.
Death was so, that down.
So yes, I have had an experience like that.
Uh-huh. You know what?
I mean, I wish I was in Angie's situation. But let's say,
like, you end up catching feelings for this chick and you liked her. Can you date a chick like that? And if you did, are you going to have a talk with her?
You have to have the talk or you have to go. Like, the way you did it was very grown, dog, because that conversation on it is a fucking hard conversation, dog, because at the end of the day, they're going to catch a little bit of, like, embarrassment. And,
no, she's going to remember that conversation
forever. She thinks about it.
Absolutely. Yes.
She, every morning, absolutely, she goes like this and she smells her cooch because of you.
And her boyfriend right now, if she's anybody, and she doesn't smell, he should thank me.
Yeah, he should.
Yes.
So I've been in the same situation, but I have.
You being with the smiley pussy
but this
girl
was crazy, right? Because I've been with bomb.
Of course.
And I've been lucky enough to not have some smelly ones, right? I've been super lucky enough, but there was one.
Really?
Okay. I know, and Rocky's going to know.
Don't say names, you guys.
No, we don't say names.
I don't say names. I'm good.
Why?
Fuck.
No,
I mean,
you guys
like
stress me out.
I'm fucking corrupt because I'm calling out names.
I'm like, what was that? I don't even know her. What is her name?
Remember that song, though? That was a good one.
That was the best song in the world, dog.
Yeah, all right. Shout out to Corrupt. Yeah. Space Boogie.
Yeah.
So, not too long ago, right? For a while, I was kind of struggling when we got this fucking building. And I was living in the fucking...
He was.
I was living in the office, right?
I like the transparency.
That smelly dick.
Yeah. So one time, there was this chick. She probably thought I was doing cool because I'm fucking Instagram doing big things. You know, I was like, you're not down, Mackie, fucking Carrie, whatever.
Yeah.
And
in friends and family.
In the friends and family. And
that pink bracelet, he's good.
Yes. Yeah. So we ended up having some drinks. And we come back here, right? And we fucking are macking down so hard.
I'm just visualizing.
And she's beautiful.
Do you
mind
I seen him kiss in a parking lot.
I'm going to let you know right now. She's so pretty. She's a real nurse.
She's not an RN.
Yeah, she's a real.
She's a real nigga.
Yeah. And we're going at it. You know, we're fucking macking down. You know, and then I'm taking her scrubs off. Now she wasn't in her work.
Cause you're not a scrub.
I'm not
scrub.
That
right
her
now.
Scrubs. I'm already gonna go to her defense.
She was
saying that was probably a 15 hour.
She
wasn't
regular clothes. No, she was a regular.
Straight up.
She's good.
If 15 hour shift to get this 15 seconds.
And she's gay niece.
She was a straight up. She just came from
It wasn't scrubs.
I didn't hear the story, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
We're doing it right. And
passion. You find your lip.
Oh, so like as soon as I take off her Fashion Nova jeans, you know.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
Yeah.
All
right. And I'm giving it to her, right? And I could start smelling it. Okay. But it's not going to stop me because I'm a soldier at war.
Right,
and
right.
Once I'm in war, there's no running back.
Right,
because you know what's behind me? The storm.
You're not a fucking pal.
I never run in the storm.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
See? So I'm going all out. And I'm fucking giving it to her. Giving it to her so good. And then finally we're done, you know? I mean,
Two minutes later, I'm done. Finally.
It was the longest 2 seconds.
She's like, I'm going to leave, you know, because I'm fucking so pleased and blessed. you know, like, thank you. And I'm like,
I could die now.
Yeah, she's like, man, I don't even care what happens right now. I could just drive off a cliff because I'm fucking happy.
Of course.
But she ends up fucking leaving. I'm right here still by myself. I'm like, fuck, I can smell that. But I'm like, maybe it's just fresh, right? Like, it's going to go away. Yeah. It's going to go away. But I end up going, I fall asleep. Right? I fall asleep on the couch.
Yo, wait, pussy dick?
Yeah. Yes, fool.
There's no shower here?
So I'll tell you what my answer to that is after. So I fucking fall asleep. The next morning, this is when we worked early. Rocky came in. Boom. All fucking aggressive. Oh, it smells like pussy in here. What the fuck?
I'm done.
Fool. And I was right away like, no. But he didn't stop. He's like, did you fuck yesterday? Who'd you fuck? And I'm like, nobody, dick. I'm over here.
Wait, hotbox the fucking whole fucking stack windows in here.
I'm over here backing up this smelly pussy bitch. Like, who gives a fuck?
It was like a gas chamber. Hey,
and I denied it. I could have been like, yeah, fool, I fucked some chick, my bad. But I was so embarrassed that I was like, nah, no, it's probably just my dick, you know? I fucking put the blame on myself. But when I don't have a shower, this is what I do. I use fucking antibacterial.
Got you.
So I fucking squeeze antibacterial, and I just kind of give myself a little bit of strokes, and I wipe off all the AIDS.
Can't get it in the hole.
You can't, because it kills 99.9%. Yes. You think I'm going to get that 1% of the bad germs?
You're a 1%er.
Yes,
I
already have that 1%.
That's true.
I can't get to double it.
That's true.
It's science. But one time, this is another quick story. Okay. One time, I had this fucking bomb baddie near. Yeah.
You don't even got to say bomb anymore. We all know.
Yeah.
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 This one right here.
We get it. Stud.
Rich, dog. Like, it's doing good.
So but how do you explain to her that? Like, you're like, oh, you want to go to my podcast, please? Like,
no, I never say that.
Like, my podcast.
No, no, but I'm saying, like, no, I'm saying, like, if you're staying here, obviously, you're not going to tell them you're staying there. You're like, oh,
no.
You want to go check out my podcast, please? And then you guys smash?
Oh, no, that was when I was living here. Like, yeah,
like that's right. How you would be like, oh, you
because you can watch Netflix.
Okay. Okay, yeah,
all right.
No, I'm not.
You're kind of killing my game.
No, this is just genuine conversation.
Now, when you're talking to a nice, what's it called? Fam? I'm a fucking cock block.
I don't ever talk to nobody, so go ahead.
All right, so look.
That's
so
harsh.
I hook up with this chick, right? And I do my fucking antibacterial thing. So I go into the fucking restroom, and I guess the antibacterial is like fucking clogged because it was dry. So I'm fucking, nothing's coming out, so I fucking hit it. Boom! Straight into my fucking eyeball, dog. The fucking, fool, not even the corner. Fool, I'm crying. I'm throwing water. I'm fucking over-exaggerating.
That sounds awful.
I'm still naked and like, you know what I'm saying? Like, all fucking.
At least you won't get pink eye.
Oh, yeah, you're gonna get
nice. No, my eye was all fucked up. It was the worst situation ever, but. Yeah, guys, make sure you don't fucking do the pump when you do the squirt on your hand.
Yeah, it's definitely a real thing. I'm not a soldier like my boy G Money, mm-hmm. but I told a story before where I was with that girl. She was like, she was a bombski, obviously. Yeah.
What's up,
and
Jessica?
She, you know, she take the pants down, smacking your neck. It just smelled really bad
right away.
I threw up.
So can women? Because you know you go
you
down.
Smell your shit.
Can you?
Yeah, there are, like, I'm working, I know when, like, I can just feel it in my body that I would never put myself
in a situation
passionate moment
gotcha.
With anybody, yes, like, gotcha. Absolutely not, yeah. Like, you're, like, especially when you get older, you know what I'm saying, yes, life changes, like, shit, you know what I mean, like, yeah. I've been in a strip club before, so then, yes, I have had an experience, maybe not.
There was a time
I met friends, we went to a strip club, and they were so hyped to get me a lap dance. Oh. And you know, now that I'm older, I can pinpoint that girl has some gut problems. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, the booty was, just, I was like, ugh, it doesn't smell like good ass. Like, it just like, I want to give her a probiotic, you know? Yeah, like,
like she had Alberto's before.
It's like Alberto's mixed with Hennessy.
You know what I'm saying?
All together?
Ooh.
Yeah, just, you could tell, right? Like, so, like, even for myself, I know if I haven't gone to the bathroom, like, I'm just not putting myself in positions, right?
As a
woman. Like, no, I just think it's just knowing yourself, knowing what you are. You know,
everybody's, like, if we're going to Rocky runs 5 miles a day, you think this fool's going to want his wife to give him head after this fool ran 5 miles? No. Like, his dick's going to stink
in
his balls.
She did last week.
Like, she's going to be so mad at you right now.
No, because
what the fuck?
Oh, did I say we're live?
You just said she gave you head with your fucking 5 mile dick.
It was a long day, bro.
Yeah.
Not a long day.
Yeah, not at all. But,
It's
she's a trooper.
By my chick, like,
fool, buy her jewelry.
Like,
or
my chick's really clean. Like, for most part, like 9% time, like if we have sex, she goes, let me take a shower first. Yeah. If you get back from a club or whatever, show I'm taking a shower first. Like, I'm taking a fucking shower.
Yeah.
Like, she's very clean when it comes to
the
that.
The dude wipes and the baby
there's
wipes.
So, there's so many things that you can
to,
do.
Like, hook
absolutely.
Your shit up.
You're going to go hook up with someone. If I'm in that position, which is not very often, it's very,
doggy.
It's very, oh no, it's very, if they're not like, they don't want to go to the bathroom right off the bat.
Yeah.
Like, it's just almost a respect of, yeah. You know what I mean? We're all raised differently. Some people don't know these things. They're not taught these things, yeah. You know?
And guys have smelly dicks too. Like, we can't just throw it all in the chair.
No, that's what 100%.
You know what I'm saying?
No, and
balls seem like, because, like, especially the back of balls, like, it's close to the butthole. Like, that just sounds like that's not a vibe, you know?
It's just, bro, yes.
Yeah.
They're not that close to the ball. I mean,
the back of the ball, like, the butthole, the taint. Like,
it's called the gooch. That's what it's called. It's called the gooch.
No, they call it the taint, too, right?
Yeah.
I just heard that from.
No, the taint.
From, what's your, that producer you like from Nickelodeon?
Oh, Dan Schneider.
Dan Schneider, yeah, he talked about that.
Fucking idiot. Poor Drake.
Poor
definitely could be. Steph is right. It could be something fixable.
What are you guys on?
It could be so many.
Yeah, but you know what?
We're
not. Steph is,
you know?
don't nod her right now.
Steph is my dog. Okay. Steph is
poor
my
Steph.
Dog.
Steph.
She's out here promoting vaginal health. We're promoting vaginal health on today's episode.
Yeah,
they're sex and smells like rubber. It doesn't matter.
Rubber. It's not like NASCAR burnt rubber.
Are you down for a little break?
If it's down, it's
we can take a quick commercial break, but I do want to get in some weird science.
We got some good shit.
It's
okay.
Going to be really good.
Are we done talking about coochies?
I think I just want to
You can talk about more stuff.
No, but I do want to ask you something because it bugs the fuck out of
me.
Go
ahead.
On Instagram,
yeah.
Okay. And we can snap on this, all right?
Go ahead.
Snap
on this. I love snappy sessions.
So,
tell me.
Angie V.
Yeah.
You work your ass off.
Yeah.
For everything you have.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
For where you live, the things you drive, the businesses you own, the trips you take, the things you do, right? Yeah,
yes.
I see a lot of these women on Instagram.
Okay.
They're in the Bahamas.
Yeah.
They're posting selfies or their bikini shit or whatever. Fine. But they say, well-deserved, hard work pays off, and they didn't spend a fucking dollar to get to the Bahamas. They have a sponsor that they post their fingernail on at dinner.
Uh-huh.
If I was a woman that worked hard like you, it would irk me for this woman to be in the Bahamas saying hard work pays off, acting like she really got herself there.
Yeah.
When she hasn't spent a fucking dollar. And don't even post the sponsor that took her there.
I definitely give credit where credit is due. Absolutely. I do believe in that. It is, I'm a person, I'm a human being.
You are, baby.
So, you know, by nature, you can have that moment where it's annoying. It is like, because I've been knowing some of these bitches, and it's like, I'm no damn well.
I'm about here.
There's different levels to like, bitch, you know, bitch, but when you're like, bitch, like, that is a level of like,
you put three eyes in there.
Uh-huh, bitch. No, you know what I mean? So it can be annoying, yes, but again, as we get older, I've just learned, I don't look left, I don't look right. What's for me is for me, and I don't have no time to worry about what anybody else is doing. Nice. So I think in my younger days, I was very like, ugh, this sucks. Why don't I get this? I work harder than this person. I'm this, I'm that. And then the minute I kind of stopped doing all those things, and it's fake. A lot of it's fake. You know, some of it's real, but I would say the majority is not. And it's none of my fucking business, and I'm too busy handling my shit to have any opinion of anybody else.
Yeah, nice.
And I think that's what a lot of people on social media and don't understand is they like, yo, y'all, if you're out here hating on people online, having time to comment negatively, you do not have enough shit to do in your life. Yeah. There, you should have no time to have any opinion on how somebody else is living their life because your shit is so great. You're killing it. You're doing what you need to do. So if you have time to talk shit, you have way too much time on your hands.
Yeah,
get a hobby. Do something to put yourself in a better
situation. I just think
it
takes our generation and people like us to go, homie, like, you don't need to fake the funk to be anybody. Like,
absolutely.
The whole social media is fake as fuck.
Absolutely.
But it's making these younger people think they need to do this to be cool and to be somebody online. When it's like, man, like, if you had the right people, you know what I'm saying, like, on your corner, you would understand that. That shit's a facade. It's going to disappear. Like,
and it just doesn't mean anything. It's like when you see that thing where they say, you know, winning on social media is like winning Monopoly. Like, it's fake money that you don't really own that shit. It's not really your thing. Like, it's just, it is. I will be that girl, that older generation person that, you know, in my day, we are, in my opinion, the last of a very great breed of human beings, and that is we've experienced life without internet, and we have experienced life with internet. After us, that's no longer, right? Yeah. They have no concept of that. So I think our generation, late millennials, we understand the world a little differently. We still work very, very hard. We understand the concept of work.
Yeah.
We kind of grew up working harder, not smarter.
We don't believe in shortcuts.
We do the work. Yeah. I want to stay on this real fast
because as far as the whole social media and thing, before we take a commercial break.
Yeah.
I see you work out like, You really work out at Orange Theory. Like it's definitely not easy at all. Like you just sweat and you do all this, but you do see the social media thing and these girls like these girls getting surgeries. And I'm not trying to tell you to hate anybody.
I wouldn't.
Doesn't be like fuck, dude. Like bitch, I fucking doing all this fucking workout right here, and this girl just goes and fucking whatever and just faking a funk
again. Coming back to growing up sucks. I was just telling Marlo today, I hate that I'm getting older because I just feel different. I see things different. Again, as you get older, shit changes, right? Like, yeah. I never had to worry about weight in my whole life. I've never had to worry about anything like that. It was like, I turned 40, a switch went off, and my body was like, not anymore, bitch.
Yeah.
I'm working my ass off. I never worked out consistently, asked Marlo. Like, it was just not my shit. I've never experienced feeling any salt, none of that. Yeah. So now that it's a reality to me, it's not easy to lose the weight. Like, back in the day, I go to gym 1 week. Bitch was right back on track, quick. That's non-existent. So I am not in any position to ever down talk anybody that would take, if you got the money and take
fuck,
like, because a bitch out here researching fucking lipo. Like, I am not, I'm still going to work hard, but sometimes we just can't achieve the things.
Even more harder after the surgery,
and you just can't achieve shit that you can all the time. So to what anybody wants to do to themselves, again, I don't have no fucking time to worry about it, right? You do you, makes you feel good, great. But I will say this, don't be someone that's preaching something that you did not do, right? So like, if you're out, that is a different story. Don't fake the funk, be real. It is what it is. But hell no, like, go ahead, girl.
That's why when Steph came on her, she just let it all, like, it was a great.
But then you can't hate on the ones that got the work.
Not at all.
And let them fucking, because then, us hating is kind of like doing the same thing that we talked about in the beginning. Like using that energy to hate on someone for no fucking reason. Like, if you have that fat ass look bomb, fuck yeah.
Let me tell you. Shit up.
But yeah, I get what you're saying. Don't like promote you a fucking trainer now.
No,
I did this by working out.
People trying to say like, if you get it, good for you. Make sure you don't shit on people that can't get that.
Agreed.
Don't shit on people. Yeah. Like, good for you. You're happy. But just, you fucking, look at this fucking fat person over here. That's not cool. Yeah. Like, you know, whatever.
Yeah, because if they had a dick shot, we're all taking it.
Dude, 100%.
I think they do. That blow thing that makes it nicer. I see it on the porn.
Yeah, they do.
Well, that's going to blow.
We'll be right back.
Play a jam. Do we have a jam?
We're still on. I'm new to this right now, but I make sure because they went black. But I put a commercial up. We're good.
post those older ladies that are like,
yeah, I want to give a shout out to the sponsors. If you could pause it, shout out to Pookie Tats. We got Octane Motorsports. We got Bobby D Presents. We got Chicanita's Chili. We got Black Widow. We got My Hibachi. We got Super Liquor. We got New York Life TV Wholesale. What's up, my Armenian brother? We got Ola Restaurant and Bar. We got Booze Bags. And we have Acosta's Tree Services. Oh, and let's not forget Everlasting Joy. And Snap Express. Don't think we forgot about you, too, my Armenian sister.
If you can feel what I am feeling,
shit,
then the truth is just,
it's about to go down.
You're my,
welcome back, everybody.
You're my,
we are back
girl.
At No Lane. We got the one and only DJ Angie motherfucking.
Woo!
Oh, we got Rocky motherfucking Nash.
Woo!
Who's been with the smelliest coochie girl ever? Was it
no? She was dead.
Tone?
No, that's Tone. Tone got that dead.
Hey guys,
Tone got that dead.
We are back in action, but let me put on this motherfucking Rocky. Let me keep that going. Keep that music going.
Can't want to get cut off if you do.
They play. Can we play one more song?
Rocky, you're very professional here.
While you go over time,
I know, but I'm just.
Let me get one more.
I'm very proud of you, Rock. Very professional.
We're getting another song.
We're going to my calculations.
I have a big announcement.
We're gonna get.
Count 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey guys, real quick, cut that shit off, Rock.
Don't make your fucking mind.
No, calm the fuck down.
Fuck up,
guys. Rocky's supposed to get fucking punch live right now.
I would love to.
You
want to
run a fade? Take off your shirt.
For we'll shut the camera off.
Take
first,
off your
bro.
Shirt, dog. Fucking right now.
Children,
right now.
Boys.
Hey. real quick, everybody. We got the motherfucking Laugh Factory once again. Woo! May 16th. Everybody, mark your motherfucking calendars. We're gonna be in the motherfucking building. What's good,
the
everybody?
The
link drops at midnight, so don't forget, everybody. We got the Laugh Factory once again. We sold out the tickets in 24 hours the first time. This one's gonna go faster, so we're preparing you guys. The link will drop at midnight. After the show, you wait a couple hours, you watch a fucking TV show, you fucking go down on your chick or you go down on your man. It's midnight. Fucking buy your tickets. Dog, do not be that person like, oh fuck, I wish I would have got a ticket, dog. Oh, can I get tickets? No, fool, we're not in control of the tickets. We can send you the fucking link, go out and get some motherfucking tickets, because you know it's gonna sell out again. This is what we do. We appreciate you guys. Don't forget, May 16th, there's a new date. The link drops at midnight tonight.
And I actually like that we have no control of any tickets. Like, I go, bro, you got to go to the link and get it. Like, Laugh Factory gives no free tickets. I just talk about, bro, if my mom and dad bought a ticket, you could buy a fucking ticket.
Facts.
Like, it is what it is. Like, if you can't, you don't have 30 bucks in. Sorry. Yeah. Angie, you probably get that. Fuck. Oh, my God.
Yeah, my phone's been going, like, nonstop. Everyone, I will say, I think I've built a really great community of people that love to support.
Yeah.
So everyone's awesome, but you know, my family real, like, I have my immediate family is like 50 people and they all have a plus God knows how many. So it's intense. I have to limit myself to like, this is what it is. If you make this, you make it in time on the list, that's it. After two.
Yeah, we're definitely excited for the Laugh Factory, man. I mean, the first time I know, like, I was low key, like, nervous, like, fuck. Yeah. I kind of never been on stage like that. And it was just kind of, now, like, I can't wait for the next one, man. And I think High Tone's been, you've been on stage, sell out concerts.
Yeah, but everything is a new experience, bro. And I felt the same way like you guys. Like, I'm on stage with new friends, you know, just a new thing, bro.
New fools.
And it was just, bro, I am so excited for the second show, man. Like, I think it's going to be better and better.
I agree. I think it'll be better.
It's going to get better and better over time. Like, because one thing, we have our chemistry right here, but we got we'll get better chemistry on stage. Yeah. It's just a different vibe. But
we never know who's going to touch the stage with us either.
It's always special guests, bro. But we don't, at the end of the day, I feel like, we don't need
you
guests.
You never know what's going to happen.
Like, we don't need any guests on here. But
it's like
Angie's
anything.
Different.
The majority,
she's
keep bomb. Going. Thank you.
Yeah.
Every time you do something, you get better and better.
So it's, we got to like, we got a lot of shit coming on this summer, and we're fucking we're very excited about it. But you want to get some weird science yet, G-Man, or not yet?
I would love to get some weird science.
Let's
right?
do it.
So weird science is people writing questions, and we give them advice, but we're very blunt, like, you're older like me, so, I know you know who Dr. Laurie is. She's very just like
a little bit. Yeah.
Oh, my husband cheated me. Well, fucking break up, stupid bitch. Okay. Like one of those things. Like
if you want to call anyone, Laura
calls people stupid bitch. Nice.
A bitch.
Well, no, she's on AM radio.
I use bitch very nonchalantly. My girls and my bitches like bitch. For sure, 100%.
There's different ways of saying.
There is. It's like
you're not down out right now.
No, you're in a mac down a fucking stud. Let's go. You're looking like a stud right now with that snapback. Cause I'm down. Too bad for me, dog. That's too vato. I know you have a wiener now.
Ready for shit, guys?
Let's go, baby.
Let's do it.
From my heart and from my head, why don't people understand my intention?
You know what time it is, baby. Let's go. It's time for Weird Science.
Where is it,
baby Carrie?
Oh, yeah.
Is Carrie like, does she get around or no?
No.
No? Of course. Then why were, there was just rumors?
Those are just That's rumors. My friend, that bro. You started.
Well, when they see her macking me, they're probably like, wow, Carrie's fucking just, what is she like freak. That? She's fucking horny.
No, we actually naughty. Have a campaign called Carrie Gonna Get Some. Because we're campaigning for her, you know? We want
I love that. Right? That's friend support right there.
It's food, just sure. Bring her over to the office.
Carrie does.
I live here.
Guys, we're very specific girls, okay?
She doesn't smell that. Like, she doesn't smell that. Carrie does.
And we don't want everybody in our temple.
Scary Carrie.
So shout out to Carrie, but she do need to get
She's like, why I even talk?
Yeah, exactly.
Carrie has a cool little body, though, huh?
Ooh, those,
Carrie is looking.
Have you seen them knockers?
Really good.
Yeah,
I love Carrie.
She calls them fun bags. I'm like, Carrie, what are you calling that for? She's like, because they're fucking
Audio's
fun.
Audio's distorted again.
Get About 5 years ago, I burned bridges with all my family and close friends. Mm. I borrowed money from them to put on an event concert that cost a lot of money to put together. The event was a total fail. I lost all my money and their money. I even lost my home and my wife and kids. What the fuck? Everyone was upset with me and would harass me for their money, so I moved away. I recently came back and they're still at it with wanting their money. Why can't they understand that the money is gone? It was a bad investment on my part. It's not like I'm out here living a lavish life with their money. What hurts the most is that my parents and brothers will not let it go. I only moved back to be close to my kids and my wife, but it makes it impossible for me to see them because I've been missing actually for at least 5 years now. I don't know what else to do. Should I just move away and never come back? Hi, I want to hear your input first.
I love this Weird Science because... First off, anytime you lend money for any type of business thing or come into it, it's always a risk. Mm-hmm. So if your family, your wife, your friends are holding that against you and having you move away for this investment, it wasn't the right thing in the first place for them to invest in. You know what I'm saying? Like, people, I've lost money on tons of things, bro. Like, I've invested in things that failed, bro. Like, I've lent people money for different business ventures and they failed. And bro, you got to chalk it up to the game. I'm tripping out on why is he divorced and why did he lose his kids over this investment? Like, this is a very weird situation. You know what I'm saying? Yes, people are going to catch feelings, but I don't think it's your fault. If you were A1 and straight up with them about what this investment was and you lost it, you have nothing to run from, nothing to hide from. Fuck them. They got to get over it and money comes and goes and that's it.
I feel there's other details that he left out, maybe.
I feel the same.
That it was a loan, right? And I feel that they thought that, hey, we're going to get this money back. Not, we don't need a percentage or a big cut. We're going to get our money back because we're lending it to you because we trust in you. Yes, not everything is 100%. But you lending that money, I don't know what you're going to do with it. Whatever. I trust your dream. Hey, fool, here's a couple racks. I know you're going to get it back to me eventually. The thing is, I think he's crying and he's bitching now because they want it back. Or they're, fool, do what it takes now to make it right with your family. Because they took that chance on you. If you can't go out of pocket now and start slowly paying your debt, then who are you to them? And another note, don't lend money to family.
Yeah.
Correct.
Don't lend money to family. Like, it's never going to work good.
You're never getting it back.
You're never getting it back.
Or if you do expect to not get
the money exactly.
Back. And the thing is, like, you're talking about your kids, and I guarantee those 5 years you were gone being broke, I mean, you probably didn't pay one child support, even help your wife out with shit. Your kids probably, like, now your wife is a single mom taking care of your kids, and you haven't even fucking gave your kids fucking money for shit.
In my opinion, based off just how that email was written, it seemed like it was written by someone, and I don't know this person, obviously,
yeah.
That really has no concept of accountability. It was very, I don't understand why they can't just get over it. If it's an amount of money that seems very high, I first of all, I just want to say that I think G Money nailed it 100%. I would have had,
you guys heard that, right?
Almost the exact same opinion.
Make a clip of that.
Clip that part. I think, but it very much sounds like this person, and I could be wrong, it's just my opinion, didn't really go out of their way to try to make it right. Mm-hmm. If you're running away from something and leaving your kids for 5 years, I mean, I don't, like, because of a money situation, you can make things right. But the whole, why can't they just get over it? Like, I was like, absolutely not. I think it's someone that just doesn't want to take accountability for
I
it.
I mean, then G-Money did say something. He said, we don't know the details, and the details don't seem all the way there, because I'm a risk taker. And I've, like I said, I've lent money, lost money. Mm. I've doubled up money for homies. I've done a lot of things. If they're A1 from the jump and say, hey, we need 100K to do this. You're not down fucking thing at the fucking SoFi Stadium.
Right.
And the event fails. They knew what they were in for. This is not, I'm borrowing $2,000 to pay my car.
I think
that's
a perfect situation. I think with G, I agree with G Money that I don't.
I'm doing good.
I know, surprising for me too. No, I think that, thank you. I think it just feels like, I don't know why. What are you guys laughing at?
Your company, your fucking comments?
Yeah, my hair looks fantastic. Thank you. I don't know. I just the gut feeling makes me feel like
he was shady from the jump.
I don't want to say shady, but maybe over promising, like, no, this is I got you, this is what it is. And I'm gonna be very honest. Is this
like
trauma?
That. Have you met people like
yes.
That? Yeah.
Absolutely. I know personally.
Like, if you're cracking, like you probably didn't need all that Fetty to borrow.
And that's to say, maybe he wasn't, and maybe he genuinely believed in this as well, and really
still owe me money for things like this.
I agree.
I feel it. Trust
but
me.
But you understand that, and I understand that, because we're also people that are we would probably be on the end of this guy, right? Like mm-hmm. we're on his end. We're not on the family end of, you know, maybe his parents lost a shit ton of money. Maybe his family didn't have it, but they believed in him. So I don't know. It's hard. I agree. When you lend people money, lend it with the expectation that you're not getting it back. I have a very strict rule with my family. You can borrow money. You pay it back. You can't borrow any money until you pay that money back. I got that a cousin sense. That owes me $60 for years. I will not lend him $1. I'm not kidding, because it is a. This is what's up.
It's the.
I know you got your income tax 3 times in between. Don't even try to play me. But you know what I'm saying? Like, you have to have those kind of guidelines, especially with family.
It needs to fix the family, and needs to fix the kid thing.
And never borrow money from your family, bottom line.
Fix your life, big dog.
Yeah.
Here we go, and stop fucking crying about it.
Don't borrow money from your family. And
why don't people understand my intention?
Oh, let's go.
All right. Second one. I'm surprised I don't got a cheaty one. All these fucking cheaters in this shit.
That's
here
good
we go.
Ones this week.
I've been married for 20 years.
Wow,
congratulations.
Cheated.
My wife knew that I like to party since we met. Ooh. During the week, I work hard, but on the weekend, I party hard.
Is this okay. Gus Buss?
We met in 1999, and she's known this. At the beginning of the year, she talked to me about changing my life because our son's going to be 5, and he doesn't want him to grow up with a father that's always partying. That's the thing. Before I got married, I told her I wasn't going to change my ways, and she wasn't cool with it. I said she shouldn't get married. She said that that didn't matter because she loved me. Well, fast forward to now, she told me if I don't change this year, she's leaving me. I'm not changing who I am. Why all of a sudden is she wrong changing away? Why messing with this? So I'm going to start with this one. Like, you guys, this guy, you need to fucking grow up, bro. Like, that was a long time ago. Like, that was like a little kid promise. Like, your wife seemed like she grew up, and that's a dumb thing for her. Like, you have a kid now. Like, they don't want a kid to be a fucking drug addict or whatever the fuck you're doing. Like, I mean, at the end of the day, like, you want to party and forever, that's your thing. But your wife wants to be different. The thing is, when you get married so young, like, you only know that young person. You grow differently, bro. Like,
if you're not growing, you're really strong at life.
It's not like he don't want to change, and that's fine, bro. Whatever makes you happy, but that's not making your wife happy. You know.
I mean, I think you're absolutely right. At the end of the day, homie, there's a simple word. It's called balance, dog. Yeah. Like, yeah, you don't need to fully change who you are for anybody.
Agreed.
You always want to be yourself, but if you're taking advantage of that situation, then you aren't growing. Now, I'm putting myself in this position because I feel like this guy is a little bit like me, okay?
Is it you?
Possibly. Me. There's a rock star in my blood, right? Like, when I don't, like, socialize and when I feel stuck in the house and when I go work home, gym, and I'm disciplined, I start to feel like I'm missing something. Like, I do need to feel like I'm partying. I feel like
you
FOMO.
You deserve it.
Yeah, FOMO?
And
bro. You feel not you deserve
even FOMO.
It.
Just homie, it's just
no,
that.
I feel
it's
I
just that when I feel caged and when I feel like I'm losing me, then I start to act out very bad. I feel like it's getting taken from me. Now, if I could be high tone.
You are.
If I could be high tone but not take advantage of that and have respect for her but still get me time, then it works out perfect.
Like, you need to visit who you are at all times, your inner child.
I don't like people that have to fully change. I'm changed now. I'm grown up, so you have to do
it.
Like, no,
same.
Bro.
I'm with
like,
you on that.
I don't. I think we grow in different ways, different times, different paths, and we always have to just revert back to being who we are.
And you said, like, you change and you just grow apart. And nothing's wrong with that. And maybe she was the one for you in that season and of your life, but now you guys just grew apart. You're different people. And maybe just get a divorce.
I'm not going to lie. He did kill me with all of a sudden. 20 years later, dude, all of a sudden, she's
no, like, if you don't want to change, that's his thing. Look, if she wants somebody different.
Sounds like the Foos partying.
Friday night, weekend.
Saturday night. Recovering Sunday and going to work Monday every single
day.
But a
mom also changed her whole aspect of life when they have a kid.
Yeah. Like, we don't know that end either.
Yeah. So like she said, like, I have a kid now, so all my life's gonna change.
I'm actually tripping that they had a kid 20 years later. Or at least it's somewhere along that line. That's 15, a long time.
At least
you
know her coochie don't smell.
It definitely.
She's not dead.
She's not dead.
She's not dead. Yeah.
Leo, I'm gonna give this guy some credit. I'm gonna give him some credit because this fool. You know how people say don't change. The homie
this
didn't change.
It was in his yearbook.
At all, this fool. Hey, stay who you are, dog. This fool stood who the fuck he was.
I'm not his word.
He didn't give a fuck. And he still said, like, babe, I'm going to be with you all week. But the weekend, I need some time to be me. And I feel I need some time to be me. Like you said, maybe he's like, maybe we don't know what he does on the weekends. Yeah. Maybe she's just complaining. But, like, I get at a point, maybe she's like, I just want you here on the weekends, too. I want you here Friday night. I want you here Saturday night.
Truth is they've grown apart.
He needs to create
that's
that balance.
That's what it is.
He
they've
needs to be
grown,
like, all right, babe, I get it. I'm going to give you the whole week because the week's not hers. The week is work, right? It's both of theirs. And then I'm going to give you a Friday or a Saturday. You could choose, babe.
Yeah.
That other day, I'm going to go with my boys because I've told you from the beginning.
This is what makes
sense. And, girl, he didn't lie to you. He told you fucking from day one. And it looks like this motherfucker hasn't changed since day 20 years later. This motherfucker's the same dude. So if you saw things weren't changing within those 20 years, guess what?
It ain't
changing. You let it happen for 20 fucking years.
And I think,
so now you want him to change? Come on, my
girl. I think, like,
yes.
They, like, at the end of the day, they just grew apart.
They grew apart
and he didn't change. He's like, he said, he's a man of his fucking word. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, she changed, but it seemed like she changed for the better. She's a mom now.
Drastically changed.
I'll give you an example. My brother, during high school and after he, you know,
packing.
He was just a straight gangbang cholo. Like with the business. So he got married young with some chick that loves cholos and the whole partying thing, the drugs party, the whole, you know, what comes with gangs.
Loves that.
Right? Went Christian. Started going to church every Sunday. Hey, baby, like, there's no drinking in the house. I don't want no beer at the house, none of this. She didn't sign up for that. Mm-hmm. Divorce. That was it. Like,
it wasn't going
to
work.
He got married too young. He changed drastically, though. Like, I'm talking about from a gun to a Bible, like, real quick. Like, she's all like, I didn't sign up to go to church every Sunday. That's not my thing.
That's hard, yeah.
So I get it. You just grow apart. And it's okay. I know, like, no, I'm divorced. But people get married so young. Like, man, just. And some people try to force it for kids. Like, I learned that, younger by seeing my brothers, my cousin, people like they try to make that shit work for the kids, but the kids is in a fucked up fucking situation with the mom and dad fighting all the time. So if you're gonna fight all the time with a 5-year-old, separate. Like separate. Like I'm not for it, but I say that like, I'd rather my mom and dad if they fight all the time than man, don't get away from each other.
You're right, Rock, because sometimes that energy when you're mad at your partner.
Yeah.
It's sad to say you will take it out on the kid. Kids. Not like necessarily you're gonna beat the kid, but that energy, you're upset. Your son could come in the room and ask you a question like, "What the fuck, man?"
Yeah,
like,
and it's like your temper, frustration.
And
it sucks.
Yeah. I've been there, bro. Yeah. I've been there, and I'll feel like shit after. You know, obviously I'll go and apologize and talk to my son after, but it should have never happened that way.
Yes.
But it's all about the toxic part you put in is going to come out, and you're going to bring that shit out to other people. Yeah, to their closest people.
Because
to the ones that don't deserve it.
Yeah. Yes, to the one. Yeah, exactly. You have a hard day at work. Guess who gets the shit in the stick? Your partner at home. Mm. Not because it's on purpose. It's because it's just coming out of you, bro.
Right. And that's just who you're comfortable with. That's the comfort of you being yourself.
So at the end of the day, Angie, like, Out of advice, words, science advice, serious advice, what would you tell this man? Like, separate, change, or what are you telling this man right now that wrote?
I think this man needs to sit with himself and look at what his end goal is with this relationship and him and who, like, where does he see himself? If he is enjoying, other than a bar, if he's enjoying where he's at, then he needs to allow himself to exit the relationship. Not understanding, he doesn't want to change. He's at a crossroad in his life. You're at a crossroad in your life right now where you got to make a decision. Either you're going to adjust with the family life or you're going to stay on that party lane. That's what you want to do. Cool. But you really need to sit and see where you see your future.
But do you see it like, let's say, well, I don't want to change. So if he doesn't, and I want to hear G Money's point in this because I know, like, if he says, no, I'm a party, do you feel like he's taking partying over his family at this point?
I don't think he's taking partying over. He's taking himself over his family
for selfish reasons.
For himself, yeah. He's picking what he wants for himself. Whether it could be drinking, but whatever. Uh-huh. He's being selfish. He's taking himself. So he has to decide: does he care about himself, or does he care about his family? That's the bottom line. That's just it.
I mean, look, the problem with the relationships to me and
it's okay if they did grow apart. That's okay. Yeah,
that's fine.
Yeah.
The problem with the relationships is each side of the. The woman, when she starts to change, she expects this person to do the same. Whatever he's in, he expects her to be in. Like, but if you learn that you're still individuals and you still have to have your little baby separate life outside of your relationship, your relationship is going to be a lot better. You cannot control what your partner does 100%.
No.
And never. They cannot be just like you either. They have to be themselves.
Agreed. I think that's a big problem, too, in young relationships. You start becoming the same person, and then you go look back, and you're like, wait a minute, this isn't me. I'm very similar to you in the sense of I have to be on the streets here and there. Like, I just like socializing.
And the same thing, like, as we get older, like, a girl we dated when we were, like, 21, like, would you date a girl to act like that right now? Like, you know what I mean? Probably not.
No.
Like, I don't know.
I
like,
know homies.
You know what I mean? But it is what it is. To each his own. I mean...
We're supposed to be changing. I hope you guys
make
it
work. I hope you guys make it work out, whatever it is.
You know what? Maybe
if you don't, I hope you guys are both happy.
Honestly, like, maybe your wife needs a friend too, like homegirls, because it sounds like she has nobody but you. So when you're gone, she's even feels more alone.
Well, it's not fair for someone to be so dependent on somebody.
Agreed with that too.
You know how that stress is to that person?
Yeah, that's too much.
It's too much for a person, bro, to have full dependency on that person.
You know, but guys, it's like really weird because you have to think about like. But to some people, they like that. They like someone being fully, like, that's what I'm saying. There's something for everybody out in this world. The type of person that you are, the type of person I am, I can't have that. No, I need someone a little more independent. They know who they are there. But there are some people out there that want a bitch, want a dude that are like, their whole life is only them. And if they don't have someone like that, they don't feel adequate. So it is very, very interesting. At the end of the day, they grew apart, it feels like.
That's
and
what it is,
he has to decide whether he's going to choose himself or his family.
And Jay Nasty was pounding hard.
But also, you guys, we do need to be growing and we do need to be changing.
Because sometimes guys are growers and sometimes guys are showers.
Exactly. 100%. You know, and the gag. Is
Yeah, but they're like little nuggets.
They're like little nuggets.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Let's do one more.
Okay, I like this.
All right.
Rocky's like leaning over.
Ready? My wife and I separated 3 months ago. This is probably the same dude on it. The whole question. Can we get so many? Like, whatever. My wife and I separated 3 months ago because I was having mental issues and it was affecting our marriage. I recently found out that she's been cheating on me with a coworker. I kind of suspected it, but I was in denial. I confronted her with proof, and of course she denied it. She turned it on me and gave me the silent treatment and got mad at me for accusing her of cheating. Here's the thing. I know for a fact she's been cheating, but I feel bad for upsetting her and bringing it up.
What the fuck?
Honestly, I just want to save our family despite everything. I love her, and I truly believe we can move past this. Is there any hope for us? Can our marriage survive cheating? I'm willing to work on it. Angie, your hands up. What's up with this fucking thing?
Go on, Angie.
I feel bad. I feel bad for the guy. It's not going to work because at this point, it's not going to work. It's not going to work.
He didn't feel that bad.
I feel bad for him because it's not. You ain't never going to make it. I do believe in you. You just ain't never going to make it. He is very clear in this that he is willing to put, even feeling bad for her, the respect is gone. I don't think that this woman will ever respect this man again. She will continue to do these types of things.
Facts.
Because he has not at one point in what feels like stood up for himself. It's like, I still feel bad. She's going to cheat on you all the time, dog. I'm telling you.
Yeah,
the trust is gone. And not even the trust, because it don't seem like you care about the trust.
This wasn't a one-time fuck-up. This is just like, bro.
Respect is gone. I don't think she's going to respect him. Because he's willing to just, it's all good. I just think it
could be vice versa. First of all, why do girls cheat and we'll never know G-Money?
We've been trying to figure it out for a long time.
The thing is,
we're going to ask you a little bit.
I say one thing, I always say it's like, somebody's going to do what you allowed them to do. Like, you know, if a guy cheats and you always take him back, he's going to keep on cheating because he knows he can get away with it. Like, you know, you give him a leash, you can see how far he take that leash. No, it's the same thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this girl say, oh, like, he forgives me. So he said, like, she's going to keep fucking a coworker, bro. And now she lost respect because you're not a fucking man.
I don't think someone says a marriage can survive cheating. I agree. I just think in this particular, from the email that was sent, it doesn't sound like he's holding her accountable.
He's just holding her
accountable enough for her to understand that she's made a mistake. He wants it too bad that I think.
I don't know.
I think if he's like manned up a little bit more.
She's on you. What's happening?
I think we're missing the big picture.
What's the big picture?
He fucking said that his wife couldn't handle his mental health issues. If your wife isn't going to support you in that time,
wow,
why are you even want to be with this 100%. Woman in the first place?
100%.
We missed the whole big picture.
I'm depressed.
I have social. I can't leave the house. It's fucking up my life. So my wife goes and cheats on me.
Yeah, I think you sound like a really great guy, a sweet guy. There's no diss on this man. I think you sound like an awesome man, but you need to find a woman.
No, he doesn't sound awesome. He sounds like a sweet man.
He
gets walked all over. Like, he's getting walked all over. No girl or no person is going to respect somebody.
That's not
somebody.
True.
I also think marriages, I think you could survive cheating. Not in my marriage.
Absolutely. You can. Some people can.
Not me.
Yeah.
But other people, I see it work.
You need to find a woman that speaks your love language, that speaks where you're at. All right. This kind of ain't it.
So Tony, you brought up a fucking amazing point, right? His mental issues, and they've been separated for 3 months, right? We don't know what his mental issues were. Right, we don't know how deep they went. Right, how bad he was, where he was in this time. Like, we could say, "Damn, what a bitch! She wasn't there for you."
Yep, I know.
Or we could be like,
"We really don't know."
Yeah. Or we could be like, "Damn, she fucking
went through all that shit."
1,000%. And what do you expect her to do, right? So we could be on both sides. We don't fucking know how deep it was. So they've been separated 3 months because it got that bad. Yeah. It got that bad where it didn't work, right? So, yeah, she's been with somebody else, right? Maybe she was seeing him after when it was going real deep.
She probably gave that
effort and tried, and it just wasn't working. Look, at the end of the day, at the end of the day, like, you got to find your happiness. And if you found it already and she's not ready for it, fool, you're going to have to move on.
Yeah.
It wasn't meant for you. It wasn't meant for you, because I get what Tone's saying, because if she was really your ride or die, she probably would have been there when you're fucking...
Agreed.
Till you're in the casket. But you also got to understand, you probably put her through a lot of shit. So it's probably best for both of you guys to go move on. And she did quicker than you. But, hey, you're going to be all right. As long you need to focus more on your mental state more than this hyena, dog.
Focus on you.
Focus on yourself. Okay. And I hate when, like when bitches say it, because you were really going through some shit. You're really going through some shit where it was fucking, you were in a fucked up situation, a fucked up mindset. Really focus on yourself. And believe me, bro, once you're happy, none of these other bitches are better. Everything gets better.
That person will attract to that energy that you're putting out.
Yeah, it sucks. I mean, cheating fucking sucks.
All right.
Cheating does suck.
One more big question.
I'm scared. I don't even want to know.
Nah, I mean, how many blacks have you been with?
That's a great question.
Yeah. Well, have you ever been with a black?
No.
Like first base, second base, third base?
No bases?
Hold on. You know what? Actually, my first kiss in fourth grade was with a black boy.
Yeah!
Are we gonna accept that?
Fourth grade.
Yeah, you would consider that racist.
No, because you made her suck your dick.
That is true.
That's the most racist thing.
I wasn't with a chick. I just had her suck me up.
Yeah. I'm going to kiss you. Okay. Kissing's romantic. That's
fucking...
My first kiss. My first kiss was with a black boy.
Wow, I like that for you.
That's awesome. And that's why you went lesbian after? That's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Wow, that's racist.
Hold on, let me think. I'm like...
Let me think. Because you look good by that black mic.
Oh, look at that.
You're sick. Damn. Get out of here.
Oh, that's eight.
My first kiss, black boy.
Good for you.
Yeah. No. So this was the question. We're going to end it with this, but why DJ Angie V? Hopefully we clip this. What? Angie. I'm going to call you Ange right now. Ange. Why do girls cheat?
We want to know.
shit. I don't know. I think, why does anybody cheat?
Why does anybody cheat?
It's all the same. We're humans, okay? Why does anybody cheat? There's numerous things. They could just be selfish. They don't care. They don't care about anything. They could, I don't know, like, just need that validation attention from someone all the time. They could be in a shitty relationship and they're being completely not valued.
Taken care of.
Why does anybody cheat? I don't think there's a specific thing. Although, I don't know, because I think men are kind of a little different on that one.
Because then you could say, like, it's a selfish thing to do, but at the same time, if your wife, your husband isn't giving up, that's kind of selfish, though, too. Mm-hmm. So, you know
agreed, 100%. If you have a partner and you understand your partner's sexual drive...
Go down on your partner a lot.
If that's what they like...
Even if they run 5 miles.
If that's what your partner is... if that's what your partner's into... Absolutely. You can't be with someone, know what they like, not give it to them, and expect them to be happy.
Yeah.
Hell no.
Because I say, like, if
your man is like G-Money and likes a lot of butt stuff,
someone else is going down.
It is what
him,
it is.
Right?
Agreed. What you will not do, another bitch will. And exactly. It goes both ways.
Do you think girls absolutely. Get, like, because when we asked this question, why do girls cheat? Like, it was all about, like, oh, you're not there for them, or there was
emotional shit.
Yeah.
I know a lot of girls that cheat just because they're hood rats. Why don't they get that? Like, because when you ask, why do guys cheat?
They're dogs.
Girls be like, oh, they're dogs. Why
in
don't they?
DNA,
like, yeah.
No, I agree. I think there's a lot of women that cheat because they're hood rats. Yeah.
For sure.
So there is women that are just.
Yeah.
What are
their, I'm telling what you, are there's just everything.
What are those hood rat Instagrams?
There's everything. Like, I know a lot of.
You know a lot of girls that cheat?
Not a lot, but yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So look.
Can you see that one?
Real quick.
I never cheated by my sister, dude.
Amorous?
Yeah.
Amorous?
Yeah.
Marlo, Carey.
Yeah.
Great question.
One of them cheated. Who was it?
Wait. What?
Out of those three, one of them cheated.
None
who
of
would
them.
You have to? You,
come on.
I hate liars. No. If there was a fire and you had to choose.
Marry, fuck, kill.
Wait, what do you mean? I'm confused. You're asking me if any of these girls have cheated?
No, they're just saying if they did,
if
who
they
would
did,
it be?
Who would it be?
Oh,
let's say you're on Million Dollar Show and then do the thing A, B, or C, Marlo's A, B, C, whatever. Who cheated? Who's the last girl to cheat?
I'm not answering this question. I'm kind of.
Wow. It's obviously Marlo because she's
looking at me.
A real quick question.
Rock, do it.
Real quick question.
This is the last
before
one.
Before we go, last one.
Hold on. This is the most important question.
This is a great question. And this is, people always send these questions in, so they want to know.
Yeah.
Kill one, fuck one, marry one, G-Money, Rocky, High Tone, go.
Boom. And you have to answer or die.
You can't think too much. You just got to start.
Let's go. Everybody's like this.
You guys, this is gotcha right now.
Don't have the shirt off right
okay.
now.
Oh, shit. Okay. Jesus. This is just, I can't, you guys, I'm dead. Shoot me now. Kill me now.
Oh, you're not dying. This is.
You guys, I can't answer this question. Yes, he's a married man. He's married to my homegirl. I cannot. This is. There's no. Out of the respect that
so
I he, have.
Wow. So you're gonna marry me, fuck me, and then kill me after?
G money all the way across. All the way across.
We all take it.
G money all three. G money all three.
First.
G money all three. I got respect.
Yeah. See, then you fucking show. I gotta kill myself for that shit.
I respect. I have respect. Okay. Hey, I was raised with respect.
Fucking. Are you cheating? Are you cheating?
Absolutely not.
Have you cheated?
She doesn't even have sex.
I hardly have sex.
Has someone cheated on you?
That I know of? This is a really loaded question. I am not a cheater.
Has someone cheated on fucking DJ Angie V? The ones on the ones and twos, the best scissor in town from what I heard. Ooh,
the best scissor.
Hey.
I don't... You know, greatest thing in the world, guys. I'm so sad you can't experience that. I definitely don't... That I know of...
Sex for me.
That I know of... In a relationship where we were exclusive to each other, not that I know of.
Good.
That okay. I'm aware of, yeah.
Hey, you haven't had stinky pussy and you haven't been cheated on. Your money.
You guys, like, I'm going to be very honest with you. I am a, like, I have not angel. Been with a lot of people.
Bro, this is crazy.
I just want to know, really me and Jimmy talked this off the air, and we know, we know, like, fucking, like,
talk about a lot of shit.
I think you're kind of, but you're in Adele's cracky, everybody's drunk.
Mm-hmm.
They all stay at your house on one bed. They're all lesbians, all femmes,
they're
all
not
pretty.
All lesbians.
How is nothing happening in that bed?
Because we're friends.
I don't give a fuck.
And me, Tone, and Jimmy, you're gay.
You're fucking bony hard.
Sure fucking.
Forget about it.
Bro.
You're you guys, so, but, you. But darts all night.
I'm you. Right? Okay. And I'm chilling with fucking Marlo. I know she's freaky, and that's my friend.
Yeah.
But like,
she's
freaky. We have a couple drinks, and she probably likes a vodka soda. Like, things are going down. I'm going down on Marlo.
You guys, no. We're just not those kinds of girls. We're watching TikToks.
No.
I call bullshit. I call bullshit.
The only thing that's swiping is my finger on that fucking
thing,
Marlo.
And you know, I've seen these girls butt ass naked.
The ones and twos on that coochie. Ring, 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 ring.
No.
That shit. Marlo's horny.
Speaking of this,
no.
We gotta cut this out.
No.
We're out.
Hey, tickets on sale.
We're ending. Angie lined us right now.
Let's go, baby.
In a couple hours. And Angie just said she's gonna fucking DJ there too.
Oh, nice.
I'm out of town that day. What day is it?
You're out of town though. Guy, thank you for playing.
Thank you for playing the Ravel Boys. So the next You're Not Down is when?
April 21st.
It's sold out already though.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Well, fucking never mind.
Oh, curious.